not to talk about, not to talk about Temple Works for a change and just talk about mounties.
Aww.
They're so cute. My friends, the mounties. Any Canadians here will know that one out of every 100 Canadians is a mountie. Chances are, if you've been to Canada, you've shagged a mountie. I certainly have, more than one. And they're so sweet. Well, they all started with the Irish constabulary. It was kind of the dress look and kind of the, you know, the wagon look, kind of, you know, new conquests as you take over new continents. They were also great friends with the native peoples of the United States who they persuaded to move to Canada. They were real Republican boys. They were always liberating moose and bison and dealing with Fort Hoopla, which was all about whiskey. They were really helping the arrival of the North. I should point out, I'm a true Northerner as opposed to you guys. How much more north could you get than the Arctic? They then came to take over the entire bloody country. They control every part. There are MI4, MI5, MI6, MI7, and now it's all love. So, things started to go badly wrong for the Mounties in about the 1930s, where they became camp. Suddenly, they weren't really about really helping the West. They were about ladies and guys and big feather headdresses. Then it was Rosemary. Rosemary suddenly involved John Wayne, involved, oh my God, Julie Andrews. It involved conga dancers. It involved totem poles. And we know there's no totem poles in the Wild West. That's in the Far West. It also started to involve girls. So suddenly, Susanna of the Mounties, she became Swedish. Suddenly, women were considered. Suddenly, women were considered for the Mounties. And as we know, Mounties have never been about women. They've been about Rosemary and getting the girl down. Luckily, there was a lot of search and question going on in Northwest Mounties, Boys on Annuals, all of this. John Wayne again came back again and again and again. This is what was really about the Mounties. Now, anyone who has heard about the Mounties knows they have black horses, but they only have 30 of them. We can't afford the rest. We're a very small country. And one out of every 100 is a Mountie. This is the musical bride that used to live next door to me in Ottawa. One day I was planting my garden with brooms, and they asked me what I was doing. I said, we're on the way to the musical ride. Now, Monty Python has a lot to answer for. They devastated us with these aspersions of sexuality of Mounties. Also, the Americans with Due South, the fact they claimed that the dog was deaf, dumb, and blind was very rude. Mountie lingerie has been a sad, sad come-down for Mounties. Both gay, straight, orgy, group sex, this is not the way we like to see things. We're a very slow-moving country, this is the way we go. Now, we're into wrestlers. Jacques Rougeur, the evil Mountie. He's been sued by the Mounties for being so mean. There's been naked beer ads, top right-hand corner. Dudley Do-Right has been shown to be more in love with himself than with a horse. Merchandising, a big, big problem. 1995, the Mounties realized the power of their brand and sadly sold it to Disney. Yes, truly. Lego got a word in, but there was a national outcry when we realized, again, another American imperialist stunt. Sadly, the Mounties have been involved with anti-imperialist, anti-Confederate, anti-independent stunts. They've sold and eaten dogs. They've been involved with drug raids. They get killed in drug raids. They promote drugs. They have ended up taking over the country in a most terrible way. At the moment, they're getting eaten by bears, the lower right-hand corner, where grow ops put bears on them. Most sadly, I guess, in the last few years has been them starting to taser people at airports who've recently arrived to see their mom and got agitated when she didn't turn up. They've sold respected Canadian academics to the Americans to be tortured in Syria. Barack Obama has never quite worked out the Mountie shtick, and the Americans never have. This is a big problem for us, because they don't realize the Mounties are still here, back from the dead, 80 years after we tried to kill them off. Which brings us to the fact that the Mounties are on the way out. They have been on the way out for 80 years, but it takes us a long time to make up our mind in Canada. We see them as American stooges, but what can we do? One out of every 100 Canadians is a Mountie. So, what's the solution? These are my three best Canadian friends on the left. Susan Pollock, she is dealing with the Mounties and their evil influence over the world in terms of fomenting revolution. On the right, Mary Jane York, an architect who's dealing with the burning down of barns. And in the middle, the famous, powerful spy. So what we're trying to go back to is the good day of the Mounties, when we were all chiseled, chinned, we've got the girl, We had nothing to do with lingerie, and we hated the Americans. May the Force be with you.